Today we are looking at the foundation. The foundation is actually what holds anything. In the building, it's actually the foundation that determines how far the structure can go, the scope of the structure. So if it has a faulty foundation and you are putting up something very high, it will come down. That's why the Bible says, let our root go downwards and our fruit upwards. So our foundation must be sure. Psalm chapter 11 verse 3 says, if the foundation is faulty, what can the righteous do? If the foundation has problems, is faulty, what can the... You are righteous, so, but your foundation has a problem. And if you don't repair that foundation and put the right foundation, your prayers, this is your deliverances, shall be shortchanged. So it's important you understand the foundation. The foundation of Christianity is holiness, is righteousness, nothing else. There is no other foundation that any man can put. Matthew chapter 1 verse 21 says the main reason Jesus came is to save us from our sins, to remove unrighteousness, to remove the sin of Adam. John chapter 1 verse 29, John the Baptist say, here comes the Lamb who taketh away the sin of the world. That's the foundation of holiness. No other foundation can anybody put. That's why God says, be you holy for I am holy. Today there is so much compromises. People compromise, they want the gospel to be twisted to accommodate their laxity, accommodate their compromises, accommodate their own lifestyle. Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 says, seek you first the kingdom of God and its way of life, its righteousness, its constitution. What Jesus came to give us is not religion. Religion fought him. What he came to give us actually is life. John chapter 10 verse 10. The thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I have come to give you life. Life in abundance. So the foundation of that life is holiness. Holiness is premised on holiness. So if you miss that, because we are living in a world of super compromises that has never been. And that is the way it is. And it showcases something that the emergence of our Lord Jesus Christ is just around the corner. I mean, look at what is happening. This scripture is clinically true. Look at what is happening in Israel and Hamas. At the end of the day, the temple will be destroyed. And that will be the last thing that will begin to happen for Israel to rebuild that temple with stones. So you must understand that if you don't make this foundation right, there will be a trouble. What is the foundation? That is the problem. Beloved, I want you to note this. When you give God room in your heart, it shows in your life. When you give the Holy God room in your life, in your marriage, in your home, in your relational activities, in your work, it shows in your life. You will begin to have the decorations of heaven, the fragrance of heaven all around you. The glory of God will cover you. When you give God room in your heart, it shows in your life. Your life becomes a compendium of testimonies exuding the manifestations of heaven. That's the way it works. The decorations of God upon an individual is never hidden. God does not bless us secretly. He gives open blessings. Blessings that cannot be hidden. And that's what I'm praying for you today. May your life be decorated with blessings that cannot be hidden. Matthew chapter 6 verse 6. He said, though you go to the private, in secret places, to serve me, to transact with me, he said, I will bless you openly. I'll decorate you openly. May you receive open decoration today in your life, in your marriage, in the works of your hands, in the name of Jesus. May your life begin to showcase the beauty of heaven. May every form of stress concerning your life today be turned to miracles. But you must understand the foundation. The foundation is holiness. That's why I'm talking about foundation today. Because there is nothing you have God did not give you. There is nothing to be proud about. That's the way it works. I pray you will never miss it in the affairs of life. What do you have that God did not give you? John chapter 3 verse 27. He said, man can receive nothing except he will be giving him of the Lord. So there is nothing. Number two, opening your heart to Jesus is wisdom that you are what you are by Jesus. So when you open your heart to God, it's wisdom that you are what you are by God. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 7. Paul said, I am what I am by God. What do you have you didn't receive from God? That's what he's saying. The very life you have now, you got it from God. Many people that are dead, that are the mortuaries, those that are buried, you are not sometimes better than them. But God kept you alive to this moment for a reason. Because he has a divine mandate upon your life that he wants you to fulfill. You woke up this morning, it's God that woke you up, not your alarm clock, nothing. Go and put an alarm clock in the mortuary. Let it begin to wake up those who are dead. It's actually God that woke you up. So everything about your life should be thanking God. That's what the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 9 verse 10. It says, the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord. The foundation, our foundation, the foundation of Christianity, the foundation of the gospel is the fear of the Lord. Don't allow any twisted message to take you out of it. There are a lot of twisted messages. People have twisted the message of grace, which is fantastic. Grace is power over sin. That's the way it was. Romans chapter 6 verse 1. He said, do we continue in sin that grace may abound? He said, God forbid. No. Grace is actually power over sin. The decoration of heaven to help us walk the works of heaven here on earth. Beloved, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Excuse me. Psalm chapter 11, verse 3. I pray today that you don't make a mistake. That is it. Psalm 111, verse 10. It says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. That is the foundation. The fear of the Lord is God's foundation for living. God's foundation for living is the fear of the Lord. If you take it away, then you are doing yourself a bad thing. That is the truth. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 9 makes it very clear. There is no other foundation than holiness. No other foundation can anybody put. He said, he that names the name of the Lord, depart from iniquity, for God knows those who are standing with him. Don't deceive yourself. Just imagine if you die today. Then your own rapture has happened. Will you spend eternity with God? It is doing righteousness that is the issue. It's not preaching it or teaching it. He said, those that do righteousness are righteous. He says, exercise yourself unto holiness, unto godliness is something you do. Beloved, the foundation of everything of living is the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord. Zechariah chapter 5, verses 4 and 3 and 4. He says there is a flying course. And that flying course, God says, will end up in the house of a thief. A thief will be cut off. It is important for you to know it. If you are there, you're stealing, cheating, manipulating, and you think you're making money, you are not making money. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 11, he says, he that takes what does not belong to him, what will happen? He said, you end up like a fool, and he will die before his time, leaving those things behind. And his end shall be a shameful end. So why must you take what does not belong to you? The foundation of living is the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord won't allow you to steal the money that is meant to build roads, and people are dying on it, on that road. Their blood is on your head. The fear of the Lord will not allow you to go and commit abortion, to kill innocent children. The fear of the Lord will not allow you to go and lie, to gossip, to manipulate, to take another person's position, another person's husband, another person's wife. The fear of the Lord will not allow you to carry the money meant to build hospitals and to bring in equipment to your country, to your area, and people are dying because of lack of medical facilities. And their blood will be upon your head. And upon the head of your children. Lamentations chapter 5 verse 7. It says, our fathers are dead and gone, but we are bearing the consequences of their sin. The righteous man and his righteousness on earth, the fear of the Lord here, impacts on the children. Psalm 112 verses 1 to 3. He said, their children shall be mighty on earth. And then, wealth and riches shall be in their house. So whatever you do here, you pay for it. Your children will still pay for it. Can't you see those of old who stole money, how they ended? So beloved, understand that and don't joke with your life. The thief attracts the flying course. There is a flying course all over the places. And another thing is that Amos chapter 5 verses 23 and 24 makes it wonderfully clear the way God works. He says, take away the noise of your songs. You see, you cannot use your songs to cover your wickedness. You are lifting holy hands in the church and you're singing. You think that will cover your wickedness? You have stolen money. You have done wickedness. You have looted. You have cheated. You have killed. And then you are in church bringing money. He said, take away the noise of your songs. He said, they are noise, they are disturbing me. It cannot cover your wickedness. Beloved, you need to examine yourself. This is the time. God is calling everyone to examine his or herself. I can assure you that nothing works in the kingdom by chance. And I'm praying for you today from the depths of my heart that anything that makes your prayers and your song to become a noise before God, I command those things by the mercies of God to be removed from you in the name of Jesus. And I pray that divine visitation will come upon you to erase frustrations in the name of Jesus. And I pray that you turn around today and become who God wants you to be. You cannot say you love God, whom you cannot see, and you maltreat human beings. The show of love is, if you love God, you will love the poor, you will love humanity, you will impact lives. You won't be part of those who debase humanity. You won't be lying against one another. You won't be manipulating, putting people down. You will think of how to do good. Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. And verse 10. Now he says, continue to do good. Don't faint so that you reap in due season. Verse 10 says, look out for ways to do good. That is serving God. That is have fellowship with God, worship him. But then after you worship God, the same life you live, not you live one life in the church and another life outside. I pray today that you'll embrace the fear of the Lord and let it be your sing song in the matchless and most powerful name of Jesus. Remember, it is loving God, loving people, touching lives positively, and serving our God. I am Fresh Fire. We are missionaries, connecting the whole world with His love and with His presence. Thank you. Until I come your way tomorrow, remember, the fear of the Lord is the foundation for living. Thank you.
Hello there.
Hallelujah.
Are you worshiping with us for the first time? Congratulations. You are most welcome into this great gathering. This is no coincidence. We believe that your steps were ordered by God and He has a plan for you. You are now a candidate of God's revival. We are a generation called to worship the one true God. We do this in spirit and in truth, in kindness and in love, preaching and teaching the word of God by the power of the Holy Spirit. Here, your mind will be renewed as we connect you to God's presence, and you are now transformed into a giant of a strange order. Welcome home.